ashwagandha's effects on testosterone. Science is showing that not only can it improve in people where testosterone is low, but even people that already have good levels, ashwagandha can further increase it. In this video, we're going to be diving into some of the science showing what's available around this amazing, amazing root, ashwagandha. We're over here at Lost Empire Herbs on our ashwagandha tincture page. You can find a lot of information about our tincture and about ashwagandha in general. Right now we want to drive down on its effects on testosterone. And before getting into that, it's important to understand this. I'd say its main benefit is helping to lower stress. And with that, you see often decreases in cortisol, which is known as the stress hormone. The important thing is to understand that cortisol and testosterone have an inverse relationship. So as cortisol goes up, testosterone goes down, and vice versa. So if you are overstressed, and many people are because we have so many chronic stressors in modern day society, then bringing that down is going to help testosterone to naturally raise. But let's go a bit further. Pay attention, guys. Ashwagandha supports testosterone and sperm health. Of course, this is something that just the research is seeming to say. Talk about it here, the excess cortisol, because of how it can, from cholesterol, that's kind of the starter for our hormone material, whether you're getting that from diet or your body produces itself. Hormones can go, and if you're handling lots of stress, you're going to need more cortisol. So the body does that, which means there's less of that starting material in order to make testosterone, DHEA, and some of the other hormones that you need. So let's dive into the science. You see, if you're reading through this, that we have references. And if we come back up to the top, you can see this. We'll be talking about, I believe it's 11 through 15 here today. So you can see it for itself. And this first one, they didn't actually look at testosterone here, but this is infertile men. And ashwagandha is helping with that. Same with this second study. So not specifically looking at testosterone, but seeing that it's improving semen quality. So semen and testosterone, there are some differences, but they tend to be somewhat related. Anabolic hormones having effects on that. In this third study, we do look again at semen quality, but specifically with the hormone testosterone. So here we look at before and after treatment, serum T, testosterone, luteinizing hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, and prolactin as well. And so this is important. This is with infertile males. So not everyone's infertile, and there can be different effects between infertile men and not. So they actually did, the control subjects were fertile men. So what they found was treatment, so in this case, use of ashwagandha significantly increased testosterone and luteinizing hormone and reduced the levels of follicle stimulating hormone and prolactin. So we see that here. And all of these are good indicators of semen quality, as I was just saying. So if you're infertile, this can definitely help. But in this next study, which is really cool, here they're looking at 57 young males. And these are healthy guys, so they're fertile in the first place. They're not having any problems there. This is a good double-blind placebo-controlled study. I believe this is done with the KSM extract of ashwagandha, so different than our product. But if ashwagandha is working in one case, it's often working in another. So here they're looking at specifically exercise, muscle strength and recovery, and testosterone levels in this is included. So what do they find? It's basically, yeah, people recovered better, they got stronger. There was significantly greater increased muscle size in the arms and chest, but not other areas, if I'm remembering this correctly. And they also see a significantly greater increase in testosterone level and also less body fat. So wow, ashwagandha is doing a lot here. So this is a very cool study to look at. Obviously, if there was more subjects, but they had 29 treatment people, 28 placebo. So that is pretty cool. And so far, we've been talking about men, but what about women? In fact, I'd say from our experiences, women tend to like the ashwagandha even more. So we don't, over here in this study, they're looking at sexual function in women. They don't specifically look at testosterone, but They're using a questionnaire, the female sexual function index and female sexual distress scale. So they're looking at some of the things, and they do highlight this. So they're saying here that testosterone has been shown to increase in men, and then testosterone can go down for women as well. It's a very important hormone for them. So it may be, they're theorizing here that increases in testosterone may be part of why it is helping with sexual function as well. And once again, this study was done with the KSM-66 ashwagandha. So if you specifically want that because it's being shown in the science here, then you're going to have to go elsewhere outside of Lost Empire herbs. But in our other video, I talk about why I think our spagyric tincture, which is grown in the USA, biodynamically farmed, spagyrically prepared, would stand up against that. So check out more details over at Lost Empire. We have a lot here. You can check out just all of our reviews, a lot more of the references, our independent third-party testing. All that's available over at the website.